Bitcoin. One credit can start to play.
Ciao a tutti amici di GameSurfer, siamo alla presentazione di Far Cry 4, abbiamo avuto la possibilità di giocare buona parte della campagna single player e ora abbiamo la possibilità di intervistare qualcuno del team di sviluppo per chiarirci un po' le idee su molti elementi del gioco. So first of all, nice to meet you, can introduce yourself to our users?
Ciao, io sono Lucien Solban, I don't speak Italian, no parlate italiano, scusi.
Perfect. You write the story.
Yes, I am one of the two lead writers for Far Cry 4, along with Lee Kuo.
Perfect. Far Cry 3 had a huge story, a lot of big charter with a lot of things to learn and to do in the game. It's difficult. Write something new, but with the same deep, because fans always wants something more, something
right.
Big.
Right. It was difficult, but it feels like we had a lot more freedom this time around, because what we decided to do was we said, okay, we want to expand on the world. We want the player to go in and find out more about the world. So the thing is that it was difficult because the amount of work that we had to do was more, because we needed a lot more systems to interlink everything together, but it was a lot more liberating because we knew that the player wanted to do certain things, we knew that the player wanted to explore and have fun, and it was easier this time around saying, well, you know what, let's give them the tools to go out into the world and enjoy themselves and still provide not only the same amount of content, but even more content.
Perfect. We saw Pagamin with the release trailer for the announce of Far Cry 4, and we connect them to Vaz,
right,
because there some connection between the two villains. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me something more about Pagamin? You start thinking about Vaz and create something new, or you just cancel Vaz because it's an important character for Far Cry 3,
right,
and write something new?
Well, that's the thing, is that it wasn't easy just to say no to Voss. I mean, Voss had such an impact that we wanted something that had as much impact. And, you know, we went around the questions of who's our next villain, what do we do, do we bring back anybody? And we decided eventually, no, you know what, let's have each game as an evolution of the last one and improve on it and show the lessons that we learned to make it better and stronger. And so Pagan Min is an example of that. Voss was like lightning, okay? It happened and we were like, wow, that was incredible. With Pagan Min, it was a lot more, okay, what do we want to accomplish this time around? The similarities that they share, where they're the same, is that in both cases, we found really powerful actors, and with Troy Baker playing Pagan Min, we said, make the character your own. We've given you the lines, we've given you the ideas and everything, and then how do you make it your own? And he did a wonderful job. He really brought Pagan Min to life.
Perfect. But you know, one of the things I really like in Far Cry 4 that you told to the players, this is your story. Write your story.
Right.
How can players can write this story into the game?
Well, the thing is that what we've allowed them to do is, if you take a look at YouTube and with everything that's happened on Far Cry 3, players were already showing their experience. It was already their game. And so we gave them more tools in order to do this. Not only that, but we've now given them the ability to choose in the mission who they're going to support out of the good guys, out of the allies, quote unquote, okay, the golden path. So do they support one side or another? What do they do? And then even in the open world, you have tons of options. How do you approach the open world? Are you going to be the sort of stand in the middle of the road kind of guy with a heavy machine gun mowing down everything coming your way? Are you going to be the type of person that's going to throw bait to attract animals and basically never be seen? Are you the sniper that's like, you know, a hill beyond where the camp is and you're shooting people? Essentially, we put in all the tools there so that the player can play the game they want, and then afterwards they can say, this is what I did. It's all about what I did in the game.
And I think that for supporting these things, you need new and radically strong skill tree, mm-hmm, for example, side mission, for example.
Right.
So you put a lot of new things also in this way?
Yes. What we ended up by doing was we already had a strong base with Far Cry 3, and then we saw what we needed to do with Far Cry 4. And one of the things that we did was we said, how do we bring the missions and the open world and make them together? How do we knit them together to make them stronger? So that's what we ended up by doing. We developed more systems to make it so that it's more of a seamless experience. We introduced co-op so that a friend can jump in and out and the friend still fits within the world because we've used Herc. It's all these different things that, you know, we've brought in to make the game better, and it's all about the player experience in this instance. But yes, we added new systems, we refined systems, and we're actually looking forward to seeing what the players end up by doing.
So we can say that the co-op, for example, is a part of the entire experience for the player.
Right. It's a part of the entire experience because we don't want it that anybody that plays co-op misses out on anything in the main path, or anybody playing the main path misses out on co-op. So we've tried to make sure that co-op is part of the experience, but I have a feeling it's going to be a really big part of the experience. I mean, when we were doing when we were showing people this and we watched people playing, you could hear the room crackle. You could see people give high fives when they were playing co-op, and suddenly it was like this charged energy. People loved playing together. Okay, and I think it's going to become an integral part of the entire Far Cry experience.
Perfect. The last question is more technical, you know. You write the story. And sometimes writing a story is not the same to show what you want, what you're writing, you know? With this new power, with this new generation consoles, PS4, Xbox One,
right,
you can now do something you can't do in the past, also in big scene with huge environment or things like that, because Kirat is really, really beautiful to
right.
see.
Right, and but the thing is that one thing we're very proud of is that across the generation of platforms, you know, there is no, both of them have the exact same content. So players that have one platform or the other, the one generation of platform or the other, have the exact same content. What this technology and what the future is going to allow us to do is not create big scenes. We never want the player to be passive. We never want them to sit back and just watch what's happening on screen. What we want is we want them to be an active participant. So what you're going to start seeing with this technology is a lot more systems that are subtly, that are there just under the surface, and that the player may not necessarily see, but he will always or she will always feel it happening around him or her. So we definitely want to make sure that the systems support the narrative and that there's more narrative systems to interlock. Bigger scenes, more realistic scenes, for us, I don't think that holds as much interest as how many hours can the player derive from that experience, from those new systems that we're putting in place.
Perfect. So we have a strong community of Far Cry series on our website. You want to say something to that player?
Okay, yes. Thank you very much. You guys have been a tremendous support. We are really enthusiastic and thrilled every time we've heard about the support that's come out of the fan base, especially out of the European fan bases and everything. You guys have been great. We listen to what you have to say. Far Cry 4 is the reason why there's so many changes and why the game is much more player-driven. It's for you guys.
Thank you. So, thank you very much for your time.
Grazie.
Ciao a tutti e alla prossima.